jump in the crowd, they was laughing at me. Who they laughing at now, huh? I laugh at myself. Some people, they looking like wow. The moment.
But I really don't care what your name is, and I really don't care if I'm nameless. Y'all just driving around, I know what my lane is.
Hockey, not competitive, this is a job for me, it's adrenaline. Don't try to box me in, I am able to come in the ring. The way better, I never die, but I live in these different. The moment you blink is the moment you lost. Say you a king, who put you in charge? Care what you think, I'm breaking your car. Climbing on top of it, sound the alarm, and wake up the neighborhood right in your yard. And carry the speakers up under my arms, so you can sleep in on me, I'm at large. No, but the jokes, I ain't joking, you come in the session with me. I'ma show you what dope is, and when I say dope, I ain't talking about I'm talking about music that has an emotion. I look at this mic, it's part of my family. Take it away, I'm coming to find you. I've been through a lot of my life, and it's hard to get people to listen when no one's behind you. And then Capital came in the picture and gave me a shot. And look at it now, I look at the team I'm dealing with. Ah, these people ain't playing around. Looking back, I got a lap. I was in a whole different place a year ago. I look at the math, I look at the map. And thank you, God, I swear it's a miracle. And I'm sorry, but I gotta leave. But man, this track was beautiful. The least I can do if I murder a beat is take the time to go to his funeral.
Hello, everybody. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. Here we've got a pair of running backs. We're hoping their number will be called plenty in today's game. It's Charles' Chiefs going up against Blunt's Patriots. So now let's go to Kansas City, Missouri, where Jim and Phil have the call.
And Steven Gostkowski looks ready to get this one underway. So that means Niall Davis will be back for the opening kick. This game has officially begun. Steps up and fields it at the two. And he's tackled right at about the 28-yard line. This quarterback, at this point, this is not a first-time experience for him. He's been in a lot of big spots as he takes the field for the first time today.
Yeah, veteran quarterbacks, Jim, you're right. It's not their first time seeing a game, situations. They're ready for everything, and their thoughts are always good.
The Chiefs break huddle and show a jumbo look. The Chiefs take it from the 28th.
Smith's able to show off the footwork. Wow, what a good job. Look at those feet. Like a dancer. Gets himself in very good position to throw the football.
Jamal Charles is in the backfield.
First down and 10.
Brings it in. And the tackle is made right around the 39-yard line.
Nice job that time of the tight end. Makes the catch, and you got to look out for him now in the NFL. Remember, They're usually the closest receiver to the quarterback. Quarterback gets in trouble, he's going to look for the tight end.
Now first and 10. And Smith just throws this pass incomplete.
He is one of the biggest game breakers in the NFL, running back Jamaal Charles.
And one of the most underpublicized, taken for granted, not talked about enough running backs in this league. Jamaal Charles has just been an outstanding player in his career in the NFL.
The Chiefs have it at the 39. Look at that concentration as he makes the grab.
Smith selling this play big time. The defense, they go for the run fake, and that's why he has time to throw the football and makes the completion. Good job.
Set up now at the 28-yard line.
Charles, the lone setback this time. Smith dropping back to throw once again. Macklin's tackled right at the 20.
The drag route is a huge part of every offense now in the NFL. It's where the receiver starts on one side of the football, goes across the field, looking for those spots where he can catch it, and the quarterback that time threw it at the right time, right on target. Good yardage, just for the first down.
Macklin's marked down at the 19. He is a former first-round pick of the Patriots, Devin McCourty.
Devin McCourty has shown everybody what a player he is on the defensive side. He's played corner, he's played safety, and man, the guy is smart. You put it all together, you have an all-pro.
And that's a gain of 10.
First down by the offense in the red zone, and you know, you're on the defensive side, you don't have to worry about deep passes anymore. You can be more aggressive and take some chances.
First and goal. And he hauls it in.
Well, that last play almost got him in here. And when you look at this, what do they do? Well, you just want to punch it in. There's a lot of different scenarios. You could do a play-action fake, probably get somebody wide open, or have a running back just jump over the top for the touchdown.
Second and goal from the 3. And touchdown, marching right down the field for an opening score. That's a big way to get the momentum in your favor with that touchdown, Phil.
Yeah, nothing like it. Midway through the first quarter, you're on top of the other team, and you just feel like, hey, we got things under control, and you're putting pressure on the opposition to go out there and try to make something happen.
The Chiefs getting ready to kick it away. Martin will drop to a knee, and this will come out to the 20. Leading the offense, the all-time highest win percentage of any quarterback to ever play the game, Tom Brady.
Tom Brady coming on the field. You know why a lot of guys don't like him? Hey, he's a good quarterback. Makes a lot of money. He looks good. I mean, come on. Can't have it all.
First down at the 20. Catches the ball on the sideline, but does not get both feet down. Now, let's talk about the offensive unit. At tight end, a man who posted record numbers his first 3 years in the league, Rob Gronkowski.
Yeah, such a big target. You know, he's an excellent blocker at the line of scrimmage, so that's nice for your run game. And even if he's not open, the quarterback still able to throw him the football because of his size and his arms and his hands. He could just go up there and get the football.
But they can't connect. This linebacking core is the heart and soul of this defensive unit. The Chiefs lined up in the nickel. Third down and 10.
The offense stopped midway through the first, and they'll now turn to their defense.
Yeah, Jim, they're going to turn to the defense. Here we got a low-scoring game, and what they have to do is go out there on the field, find a way to stop the other offense from scoring some points.
They're in punting formation. Thomas got it now. Collins is there to make the stop. That return's good for about 7. The Patriots allowed a ton of passing yards on that last drive.
Yeah, look, I'm not going to fault the players. I think the coverages that they used in that drive were wrong. They've got to change up this time to give the players a better chance for having some success.
The Chiefs come out in a jumbo set. And now here's Charles on the toss.
The Patriots guessed right on the defensive side that time. They thought it was going to be a run play. They were all over it, and they got it in the backfield and made the tackle.
The Chiefs have it at the 34. Charles is going to receive the toss. That's McCourty making the stop. We're early in this one, but already a crucial third and... The Chiefs will look to get to the 45 to pick up a first down. Got drilled as he throws it.
The Chiefs really don't have much of a chance of picking up this first down. It's third and long. Of course, the defense is looking for passes down the field. They're all over everything, and the pass goes incomplete.
Amendola is going to look for space now. Ball is out. Touchdown, Kansas City.
That's the way they're taught, to be greedy. Don't be satisfied with just getting the turnover. Take it all the way back to the house for the score.
The Chiefs for the extra point. It's good. The Patriots prepared to return the kick. Martin's not going to test the coverage this time as he takes a knee. The Patriots offense failed to muster a single first down the last time they had it. Let's see if their offense this time can create a few sparks.
Well, you know the coaches were upset at them when they went to the sideline, so the sense of urgency is there. You should
intercept it. All the way home and all alone. Touchdown.
When a defense intercepts a pass like that and scores a touchdown, boy, does that give them hope. Gives them a lot of confidence. They really get the momentum on their side, and it's going to be hard for the offense to come out here and do anything after that play.
The Chiefs with an extra point try on the way. Inside of the uprights. The Patriots have really just been outplayed in every facet of this game. Really just looking for any sort of answer. The score's 21-0. Smartly takes the knee in the end zone. The Chiefs' defense buckled down the last time and got the takeaway on the interception.
Yeah, give the players some credit, but also give the coaching staff a lot of credit. They were calling aggressive defenses, and when you keep being aggressive on the defensive side, sooner or later, you're going to get that turnover.
First down at the 20. Still on his feet.
I don't know if that was a good run, break, or just bad tackling. Whatever it is, they get a few yards.
Brady is in the shotgun. Stands in the pocket. It's caught by Blunt. Good yardage picked up on that call.
What's the old expression? Just move the chains. That's what they did with that throw and catch that time, Jim. It also gives them a chance for three more downs.
First and 10. Brady, handoff.
This is one good tackling defense. They stay in good position at all times, and we saw it that time, and they stopped the play for a short gain.
Second down and 7. Looking across the middle, and he's tackled, but not until he picked up the first down. The Patriots still possess the football as we begin the second quarter. And the second quarter is underway with this snap. He'll pick up 7 this time. That's his first reception today.
The Patriots coaching staff, they have been smart today. They are keeping everybody off balance, even me. I thought for sure they would run the football, but no, they come out on first down, they throw it, they pick up solid yards. Good job by them.
Good throw and good catch right on the sideline.
Well, you get a couple first downs on a drive. It just, of course, it makes you feel good about what you're doing. It loosens up the offensive play caller, and there's nothing like dictating to the defense.
I love it.
First and 10. Locked in on the football and has hold of it with 2 hands. So they complete that one, yet it's still second down. Snap back to Brady from the gun. And it's caught by LaFell. And that's Johnson in on the stop.
Good job by the offense getting the first down in the red zone. Now it becomes tricky. Can you deceive the defense where you get a chance to get a score?
Brady's completion percentage, 60% on the day. Lewis has got it on the handle.
Oh, my gosh, it is the worst thing you can do on the offensive side. This drives coaches crazy. When you get down near the goal line, you run the football, and you lose yards. That's just not being tough enough.
Second and goal from the 9. Loss of a couple that time. Peters is there to take him down. They're just grinding away down here, inching closer to the end zone.
Well, that's what you got to do sometimes. It's hard always to think that you're going to come out and just make big plays. You got to do the dirty work, and this offense is doing it right now.
Got hit on release.
Well, the defense has got to love that. They love it when a quarterback is uneasy for whatever reason or just not in rhythm. That time they see him throw off the back foot, and the throw goes incomplete.
The kick is good.
Yeah, that was a good job that time by the defense. They were bending. They did not break. And all they did was give up a field goal.
Gets out past the 20 and brought down at the 24. The Chiefs weren't able to get anything out of their last drive and were forced to punt as they take the field here. Do you think they are going to vary their approach, Phil?
Well, I hope so. I think they will. They got a lot of information out there in that short drive, Jim, and you do that by showing different formations and plays. You saw how the defense reacted to it. Now you counter-react and see if you can get some positive play.
I'm sure they're tired of being in the three-and-out business.
No, it's a bad business to be in. I know. I get in a lot of bad businesses.
Smith's got 2 tight ends on the field for this snap. 2 hands on the football and has the catch.
That was a nice job by the offense. It just puts him in a better position. Nice little throw and catch.
Smith's going to take the snap from the shotgun. It's third down coming up. The Patriots with a nickel look here on defense. Alex Smith from the gun. they take the football onto the opponent's side of the field. You knew this was going to happen, and the coach disagrees with the call on the field. So now they're going to take a look at the replay and try to determine if the spot of the ball was accurate or not.
When you talk about challenging the spot of a football, it has to be a clear-cut decision for the official. They're not going to move that football 2 inches or 3 inches. It has to be at least a half a yard before they're going to change what they see on the replay.
After review of the play, the ruling on the field stands.
The coach's challenge is not answered. The play on the field will stand.
Yeah, that's a tough. You know, I think it was up to me in this situation in the game. I would not have challenged, knowing those timeouts, how important they are. We'll see if that lost timeout comes back and hurts him.
And they'll run the football with Charles. The Chiefs turn the ball over on downs.
The Chiefs that time go for it on fourth down, and they fail. I did not understand the decision, but you got to make sure your team doesn't get down from that. You got to keep them up.
Loss of two on that play. First down at the 49. Takes it on the counter.
The Patriots offensive coordinator, he has to be frustrated by that play. I think he calls the right play, but what happens? The run loses yards. That's just a bad job by the offensive line.
Second down and 12. Up the gut here. Gains five.
Got to give a lot of credit to the defense. They were all over the run that time, and they only give up a short gain.
Coming to the line at the 48. Halftime, 2 minutes away. Welcome back, and we're coming out of the two-minute warning. Lewis is split out wide on the left. Brady's got it in the gun, and it's hauled in by Edelman. That's his first reception today. They're going to the hurry. Back to the line now. First down at the 39. And there's Edelman. Gains about three.
Do the little things right. When you do those right, you get big victories. And doing it right is what this offensive player did that time. Had a chance to get out of bounds, stop the clock, give his offense more chances. Really good job by the offensive player.
And Edelman can't hold on that time.
Well, sometimes when you have a talented receiver, you just got to put up with plays like that. He might drop a few, but when he does catch it, he can make a big play.
Third and seven. Houston takes down the quarterback. That's a timeout by the defense. All set to punt here. And that punt is going out of bounds. They are not going to allow them to return it. The Chiefs were fortunate to get that explosive start, because ever since then, the offense hasn't really moved the football all that much.
No, it's been a struggle here of late, but does give the team, the coach has made some nice adjustments. He's helped the defense, and he's kept them in the lead.
The grab is made by Kelce. Kelce's marked down at the 27. Quickly to the line. Second down and five. Alex Smith looking long. A nice grab. No doubt he was going to hold on to that one. The Chiefs call a timeout here. They have zero timeouts remaining. At the line of scrimmage, the 34. Let's see how they back up the big play here. What a hit that time.
Well, they always say if you get your hands on the football, you got to make the catch. Yeah, right. The guy that made that rule up wasn't getting hit as he was trying to catch the football. Nice hit that time by the defender.
Second and 10. one-handed catch. Macklin's got it on a pass, had some heat on it. The defense at this point trying to keep him out of the end zone. Smith's back at it now, dropping back once again. Travis Kelce comes down with it. Second and goal from the five. The draft.
Well, I tell you, it's getting ugly out here.
Nearing the half, and this one is a laugher.
Oh, well, yeah, one team's pretty happy about it, but how about on the losing end of it? How would you feel like to be being blown out here right before halftime? It's a terrible feeling, and I don't know if you can regroup in the second half.
And Amendola's running this one out. And he's tackled just past the 20. We'll mark it at the 22-yard line. The Patriots bringing their offense onto the field. It wasn't a very productive possession for them last time out, partner. They ended up punting.
Well, you know what it was? It was a good feeling out process. So they got some knowledge by watching the defense and what defenses they tried on them. So you've got to take advantage of that knowledge and come out here and make some plays.
Mercifully, the first half has come to an end. We have a blowout on our hands here today. Larry is coming up with some very one-sided highlights. Jim Nantz, Bill Sims here at Arrowhead Stadium. Third quarter about to commence. And a flag comes out.
Personal foul. Face mask. Defense.
Grabbing the face mask. We see it almost once a week, and here it happens again.
Well, a lot of times these defenders, I'll give them a, you know, a little slack because they're running so fast. They're trying to tackle some tremendous athletes in open space, and sometimes accidentally you're going to grab the face mask.
The third quarter begins with this play. And off the mark on that short throw. After the incomplete pass, it brings up second down. Blunt. Hollies, the one who made the big stop.
Well, it's third long. I just say this, be very careful on the offensive side.
This is third down. The Patriots come to the line. First down marker is at the 48. Brady's going to take it from the gun. Catch made. He's brought down. That's going to bring up fourth down. We're not too far in the third quarter, Phil, but I can't see this defense today yielding a lot of points in the second half. They've been sensational.
Oh, the defense is doing it all. You are right, Jim. And they, hey, look, they're telling their offense, look, if you guys don't blow it, make some big turnovers, there's no way we're going to lose this game here today.
And a touchback. The Patriots' secondary could not stop the pass on the last series.
Well, they were just too timid. They were giving up too much room, making some of the throws too easy for the quarterback. Man, you got to man up, get up there tight, and cover these guys closely.
Charles is tackled down after a gain of five.
Good job that time by the offense. Power run gets him a few yards.
The Chiefs come out. Jumbo package on the field. Second down and five. They'll run it off the toss.
This is an awesome job by the head coach, the offensive coordinator, and the offense. Just keep picking up those first downs. You got a big lead here in the second half. Keep that clock running.
First down at the 37. He's wide open for the grab. That receptions on the day.
Good job by the offense here with a good lead in the second half, picking up that first down, and that's what you want to do. Take your time, look at the play clock, take it down as low as you can, and keep picking up those first downs.
First down and 10. He makes the catch. Sherman's tackled down at the 31. The Chiefs are in front thanks to their quarterback. Smith's done everything he can to keep his team on top.
He has been so efficient here today, very smart, making decisions. And when you put those two things together, that's why your football team is winning.
Jamie Collins gets to the quarterback.
When you talk about a blitz on the defensive side, it's all about timing. Disguise it to the last second and time up the snap of the football. They did it that time, and they get the sack on the QB.
Away from the ball, there's a flag down the field. He's tackled beyond the markers. It's a first down.
Holding defense.
Bill declined the penalty and let the play stand. Play number 6 coming up on this drive. First down at the 20. Reaches out and grabs it. Picks up about 5.
When you talk about throwing the football into open space, that's almost always against zone defenses. That's what we saw that time. Good job of the quarterback throwing it in there.
Second down and 5. He's got the catch. Sherman's tackled down after a gain of 15.
Jim, the defense gives up the first down that time inside the red zone, but there's only so many things the offense can do. Let's see if they can hold them.
First and goal to go. And they'll give it. Touchdown. They're just running it up. We're late third, Phil, and kind of like looking at you, this game is getting uglier by the minute.
Wow, you know, and everybody says you're a nice guy. Now, see, you say things like that, and you just ruin your reputation. A man of the people, heck. Oh, well. Well, you know, Jim, sometimes you got to say mean things. This game has been mean, too. One team is getting blown out.
And this is Martin running it out. And they stop him from running it out to the 20. Mark him down at the 19. The Patriots have had a game they'd like to forget, and it hasn't been getting any prettier for them in the second half.
Well, sometimes there's days like this, Jim. You know, I don't know what it's like. I've never been in this type of situation, but it's been rough out there. It's not going your way, but just hang in there.
First down at the 19. Looking for some daylight up the middle. He's averaging about 4 yards a carry.
Well, he's in the NFL because of this, because this guy can break tackles. Good job on that play.
The Patriots will take the snap from the 25. Smith's there to make the tackle.
Good coaching on the defensive side. Everybody stays at home. They stay in their gap. And they hold that run to a short gain.
The Patriots from the 27. Well, they convert this time, but they've had a tough time all day long on third down.
Well, you're really in a tough spot, but that is a good job picking up the first down. You're down big in the second half. All you can do, just keep picking up those first downs. You hope it leads you to a score, and then you play the game from there.
First down at the 35. Edelman with the reception. That's his of the day. How about the way he always locks in and concentrates on the catch?
Man, he's got hands like glue. When you shake his hand, he can break yours because that's how strong they are. So not surprised to see him just reach out and just snatch the football out of the air.
Brady's completion percentage, 60% on the day.
Sometimes when you have a player with this kind of talent, you're willing to put up with a few drop passes because when he catches it,
he has a chance of going all the way.
Second down and 10.
LeGarrette Blount with the grab.
That's a gain of 10.
The fourth quarter about to get underway, and there's not much left to do in this one other than to run out the clock.
Yeah, that's what you hope to do on the side. When you're winning a game like this, you want to run the clock out. And you know what, Jim? On the other side, they want that clock to run too because they're just trying to find a way to get out of this game. The defense, they have a lead here in the fourth quarter, so they're willing to give up short pass completions, but good job by the offense.
The Patriots at the line of scrimmage with their set of receivers in a bunch formation. Second down, 3 for the first. Look at that concentration as he makes the grab.
Well, that'll make you feel a little better finally getting a first down. You're down big in the second half, and you're on the offensive side. Don't look for the quick score. Just look to pick up positive yards and hope it leads you to a score later.
Now first and 10. Gets about 9 on the play. He's averaging about 4 yards a carry.
The Patriots, they believe in their offense. They know once they get inside the red zone, they can run or throw. That time they run the football, and it picks up some good solid yards. Great job by the offensive line.
Brady from the gun. LaFell comes away with the reception. I don't know how much it means to him at this point because they've lost the game. In fact, they've been blown off the field. But a chance to score here in the late stages nonetheless.
Well, I'm being a little sarcastic here, Jim, but this is where you want to get that stat. So if you're the quarterback, even though it's been a bad day, you would love a touchdown throw here because always that looks good on the stat line. Just keep playing the game. You're down here near the goal line. You're getting blown out. But keep playing hard. You never know. Next week, you might be in the same situation. And you can draw on this positive reinforcement maybe you get from this next play.
Takes off for the end zone, and he's got it. Touchdown. It's early in the fourth quarter. They put a touchdown on the board, and a little respectability comes with it, Phil.
Yeah, it does. There's nothing like doing something well in this game, even though it's been one rough day, and you're going to lose. But that drive, that was impressive. A lot of good plays were strung together, and you finally get that touchdown you've been looking for.
Signals made, and the onside kick works to perfection this time. Play number 12 coming up for the offense. Brady is in the shotgun. It's Gronk. Parker's in on the tackle.
The Patriots did a good job that time throwing a pass on first down and picked up some nice yards. Now second and short really puts the defense in a tough position.
Brady's completed his last 6 passes. Locked in on the football and has hold of it with 2 hands.
All you can do is your job, and that was a good job by the offense, picking up the first down. You're down big in the second half. Hey, don't worry about the score right now. Just find ways to execute plays and get down there and score a touchdown.
We'll go ground, and that's a 2-yard gain.
Well, Jim, that's a tough play call right there, running the football. When you're down multiple scores here late in the game, you only pick up a couple yards. I don't think you can afford to make those kind of decisions.
Brady's lined up. 2 tight ends set. Second down and 8. To the ground. Lewis marked down after a gain of 9.
Well, you're really in a tough spot, but that is a good job picking up the first down. You're down big in the second half. All you can do, just keep picking up those first downs. You hope it leads you to a score, and then you play the game from there.
First and goal. Lewis is going to secure the handoff. It's Eric Berry who brings him down.
What a good job by the defense, not being fooled. Here in the fourth quarter, they're leading. You expect the offense to pass, but they throw a run in there, and you're alert, and you stop it for a short gain.
Second and goal from the 6. Another handoff. Patriots in the end zone. Finding the end zone for the second time.
Not everybody's able to run the football in.
near the goal line for scores anymore in the offense. It's just too hard. But this offense, tough. The offensive line, give them credit. They gave the running back enough room, and he got in there for the score.
The Patriots setting up now, trying to recover an onside kick. The receiving team has the recovery. The Chiefs ready to go on the march again, and that's exactly what they've been doing here lately. They've taken it all the way down the field on the last two possessions for touchdowns. Phil, can they make it three straight?
Let me say this to you, Jim. It's just not that easy. As we're watching this,
intercepted. Tackles made. While meaningless this late in the game, the coaches are always looking for a morale-building moment for next week, especially in a game this lopsided.
Yeah, you know what you do as a coach? You keep teaching your guys and you keep inspiring them on to keep doing the best they can, because you will be rewarded with a good play late in the game like this. Even though you're getting blown out, it's a great teaching situation, and take advantage of it.
Second and 10. Julian Edelman has the catch. We've hit the two-minute warning in the second half. Welcome back. Coming out of the two-minute warning here in the final quarter. The Chiefs go with the dime formation here on defense. First and goal from the five. Great pass. Great catch. Great control.
The offense is so close right here. They just need to show a little power and punch this in the end zone and get that touchdown.
The Patriots come to the line, and they put their receivers in a bunch formation. Second and goal from the two-yard line. Touchdown, and they cut into that lead.
Tight ends are a position where you got to be able to do it all. You got to be able to block, run routes, and you got to be able to get in position so you have a chance to catch the touchdown pass. Good job by the tight end. Touchdown.
The Chiefs have blown a big lead here in the fourth quarter, and the score's 35-24. Everything hinged on them recovering that onside kick, and they failed to do so.
Well, Jim, when you're doing the onside kick, you really got to hope for that perfect bounce of the football. That time it did not happen. That's why they didn't recover.
The Chiefs back onto the field. Of course, the last drive they had it. Looked like they were going to put up some points, only to watch the football get picked off in opponent's territory.
Smart defensive coach they're going against in this game today. He knows how to put his players in positions to make plays, and he did that last drive, and they came up with the INT.
Was that on the quarterback, or was that just a great play by the defender?
I'm giving most of the credit to the defender. It's just a good play.
Tackles made, and that'll move the chains. And the defense will use one of its timeouts right here. Charles lined up in the backfield. First and 10. And here's the toss. Charles is tackled down after a gain of 12. And there's a timeout, so we'll take one with them. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports.
Nice situation here for the offense. They're winning the football game. Now they're in the red zone. Let's see if they can come up with a play that fools the defense.
First and 10. Gets it out for the completion. Charles, the lone setback this time. Second down and 10. Third down. The Patriots defense now is going to go nickel. And it's knocked down.
Things get tight down here in the red area. I got to give the defensive man a lot of credit, though. In position, sees the ball thrown, and is able to get that hand up there and knock it down.
And that field goal pretty much locks it up. We don't expect any once-in-a-lifetime comebacks on this situation.
I don't expect that. Now it's time to just start thinking then, having good thoughts in your mind. Don't do anything stupid. Enjoy the fact that you played well all day long, and victory is in grasp.
First down. Pressure on every snap now. Brady standing back in the shotgun, ready for the snap. Surveys.
So many times when you drop a football in the NFL, a pass like that, it's because of lack of concentration. You're just not serious about what you're doing.
Second and 10. Launching it deep. And that was close to an interception for Barry. They went for the deep throw, but the defensive back was there.
Yeah, good job that time. I got to give the defensive back a lot of credit. He was not caught sleeping out there. He was alert, read the right keys, and he was right with the receiver to knock down that deep throw.
It's Brady down the field. Comes away with it. That's his first reception today. Now on first down, every snap crucial the rest of the way.
I think what you find out about your offensive lineman, what kind of shape you're in, it's late in the game, you have no timeouts, you got to go to this hurry-up offense. Let's see if they can make it work.
Second down and 10. Brady can't find the target. Incomplete.
Well, when you get in a situation like this, Jim, and you get third and long, I'll tell you what catches a defense by surprise. Run a double move on the outside against the defensive back, because everybody in the stands and the defensive players all think you're going to throw it short.
Looking long. It's intercepted, and that's going to end the comeback attempt. What a horrible time to throw the interception. But hats off to the defense here, Phil. They come up with the stop, the play, the takeaway at just the right time.
Yeah, listen, I give the defense all the credit in a situation like this. You know, they took advantage of a quarterback who they knew was going to have to take a chance, and they were ready to pounce on it.
Yeah, I love situations like this. This is when I was at my best, getting in the huddle and telling everybody all the things. Put two hands on the football. Don't anybody jump off sides. Don't take any chances. And most of all, stay in bounds.
Phil, before we go, how about this win? How much will this one count?
You know, Jim, all wins are nice. This one was done easy. You didn't have to sweat too much over it. You feel good, and you just enjoy the next couple days.
For Phil Simms and all the crew, Jim Nantz saying so long.